In his letter returning the National Local Content Bill for reconsideration to Parliament, President Yoweri Museveni described as impractical Section 26 of the bill, which had the effect of imposing local content obligations on resources obtained internally and externally on grounds that each development partner has its own policies and guidelines which are negotiated prior to the commencement of the project. However, Patrick Nsamba, the Kasanda North Member of Parliament, while appearing before Parliament's Finance Committee to defend the National Local Content Bill 2019, tabled a list of 36 road projects constructed on taxpayers' money and loans, but all these contracts were gifted to foreign contractors.
When you look at these projects across just in one sector, the road sector, all these projects, about 7 trillion, Mr. Chair, is given to Chinese company, mainly, almost 90%. Just look through. And when you look at these companies, the Chinese companies that are doing the work here, there is no way they can compete with our local companies.
Among the projects included the 1.7 trillion Kampala Entebbe Expressway loan from Exim Bank China, gifted to China Communications Construction Company, Hoima Kaiso Tonya Road using funds from government at a cost of 360 billion shillings that went to Turkish firm Colin Construction Company, as well as the Kanoni Sembabule Villa Maria Road at a price of 239 billion shillings and given to China Railway Engineering Group, among others.
Here you are, you're having Chinese companies. By your law, they will be more competitive. They have more money, they have more experience, they are more likely to win the contracts you have using your own law. So for us, with the local content law, we are saying, let us come up with an affirmative action law that will give opportunity to Ugandan companies to participate in the development, especially where public money is used.
Nsamba asked the committee to reject the president's recommendation to have this clause deleted, arguing that such terms and conditions should be fronted by the Ugandan team during negotiations.
We have a feeling that where public funds are used, like it is elsewhere in other countries, economies that support their own, wherever we have our own resource, we must utilize the resource before we prefer foreign.
Where committees worked, did work, it is unanswered, finished. We carry that forward. We address the concerns of the president, and then we move forward. But for information purpose, you can brief members just generally.
Nsamba, while defending the bill, argued that the Buy Uganda, Build Uganda policy, which seeks to increase consumption and utilization of local products and increase participation of locally established firms in the domestic trade, hasn't been fully operationalized due to lack of an enabling law, non-existence of implementation modalities, and lack of sanctions on non-compliance.
We have also provided for employment, where we want to look at citizens given first priority. We have expatriates that come here and live here forever. In other countries, they bring you as an expatriate, you given someone to train, within 3 years, you leave and go back. We are sure that within 3 years, you'll have trained a Ugandan.
The lawmaker who moves the bill as a private member also wants evaluation of local content obligations to be done to every project at its commencement.
Local content is given at the beginning of the process, not at the tail end, because the current procurement laws evaluates local content at the extreme end, where all the people would have been beneficiaries have already lost out. So we are saying at procurement level, as they send out the bids, they must indicate which local content requirements must be fulfilled.
However, the Committee on Finance is still asking itself how procurement standards set out by development partners like World Bank that can't be varied or negotiated will abide by this will. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.